We now move forward to boxing, and we welcome in Britton Harden into the program. So, humongous news, and it involves HBO Sports simply dumping boxing after 40-plus years. Here was part of their statement. Boxing has been part of our heritage for decades. During that time, the sport has undergone a transformation. It's now widely available on a host of networks and streaming services. There's more boxing than ever being televised and distributed. In some cases, this programming is very good, but from an entertainment point of view, it's not unique. This is not a subjective decision, said Peter Nelson. Our audience research informs us that boxing is no longer a determinant factor for subscribing to HBO. There's plenty of boxing out there, but what we have not seen is a lot of signature destination fights. Then via the New York Times, HBO Boxing's base is roughly 40 million, but according to Nielsen, HBO Boxing telecasts in 2018 averaged less than 1 million viewers, or about 2% of the total audience. What does this now mean for boxing, Britton?
Well, you know, like Peter Nelson suggested, you know, there are a lot of destinations to watch your boxing. You know, you have DAZN, you have ESPN, you have Fox, and you obviously have what was HBO's ultimate competitor in Showtime over recent years. Ultimately, you know, what he said is true. Boxing is in a really good space. It's healthy. You have a lot of destinations to watch the sport. But, you know, this does really sting because of the historical value that HBO brought. You know, the HBO was the heart and soul of boxing for so many years. It's going to be hard to imagine watching a boxing telecast without Jim Lampley's voice, without Roy Jones, his expert commentary, without Max Kellerman and the way he's able to make boxing so easily digestible for, you know, the common sports fan. Yeah, it really is a sad day in the sports world, in the boxing world.
Sorry to cut you off there. I also remember that when Mike Tyson was coming around and had his ascension, that was HBO Boxing. It is rooted in the historical context of the sweet science, and it's just sad that it's now coming to this day where they're saying, nope, it's not worth it anymore, not enough of an ROI to continue. And yet here are, well, you listed a few, some of the boxing free agents that could have another network of a destination: Canelo Alvarez, Gennady Golovkin, Brandon Jacobs, and then you mentioned two prestigious analysts in the game with Max Kellerman and Roy Jones Jr. Firstly, at the top of this list, what does this mean for Saul Canelo Alvarez?
You know, that's a really great question because he is obviously signed with Golden Boy. And Golden Boy, to its credit, had been loyal to HBO or seemingly, you know, when Top Rank decided to go elsewhere, when, you know, the Al Haymon relationship and the PBC relationship didn't manifest at HBO. So, you know, he's obviously going to look out for the best interest of his fighter. He's going to try and get him on the best network where he can be seen by the most eyeballs. I have a theory that will be Showtime. And you know that there's a lot of exciting fights to be made on Showtime if he goes that route. You know, you have the Charlo fight, which Jermell Charlo is the mandatory for the WBC belt. So maybe we see that fight sooner rather than later now.
What happened with Al Haymon, in your opinion, with HBO?
In my opinion, I think that he just held a lot of the cards. And he probably just had a little bit more power than the networks, you know, appreciated at the time.
Mm-hmm. All right. Lastly, DAZN has come about. They had the streaming provided service for Anthony Joshua in his last fight. They have really invaded the space here and they've hit the ground running. Do you think that many in America are going to subscribe to DAZN, or is there just going to be loaded competition if CBS puts on another Saturday or Sunday morning, afternoon, evening card? Showtime is always going to be there. ESPN, Fox Sports 1 with the PBC. Do you think everyone is going to buy into DAZN, or is it going to take a while?
Well, I believe it's pronounced DAZN. To answer your question, I do. I believe that, you know, now that the landscape is one superior platform less, conceptually, if you have the goods, people are going to watch you, right? So we don't know what's going to happen with the Billy Joe Saunders, Demetrius Andre fight now. The Billy Joe was that he's tested positive for a banned substance by VADA. This news was released last night. But you know, that's an awesome fight. It's 100 in a 160-pound landscape. You got Billy Joe, you got Demetrius, you got Canelo, you got Gennady Golovkin and Jermell Charlo, right? You're going to want to watch those fights to see how that landscape kind of pans out. So I do kind of think that, you know, people are going to, you know, take to DAZN now that HBO is out of the picture.
All righty. Britton Harden joining us. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
You know what's my favorite song? You can ring my bell. So do it, why don't you? Ring the damn bell and download the TYT app. Available on Android and iOS.